Okay, so the solid diagonal line has to become perpendicular. So what is the solid diagonal line that I have given? A and C1. Where is A? It's over here. Where is C1? It's over here. So this line which is parallel, it has to become perpendicular. So this line, just randomly you draw a vertical line. Okay, top tip you call it as A. Top tip you call it as A. In between you have so many measurements to cut. So from A, cut an arc for O. From A, cut an arc for A1. From A, measure it and cut an arc for C. From A, you measure O1. From A, cut an arc for C1. Okay. Then later, A to D, C to D. A to D, C to D. Same way over here, this will be D1. Same way over here, this will be D. Same way over here, this will be D1. So, outermost boundary line dark, like how we have done it. A1 red face, it has to be drawn dotted. So this face is red line. This face is dark line. Here to here it is dark. Here to here it is dotted. Draw projection line from each and every corner. Okay. Very first line. This is A. So this is A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, O dash. Similarly, A1, A1 dash, D1 dash, C1 dash, D1 dash, O1 dash. Outermost boundary line dark. So A1 to B1, B1 to B, C, D, D1, A1. C1 and A are the 2 points which are not at touch. A point is very perfectly so A related phase will be dotted. So A to B dotted line, B to D dotted line, A to A1 dotted line, C to C1 dark, here dark, this is dark. So this is how you are going to get your third position in the hexahedral table. Okay, slightly tricky, so you have to be very good in knowing the problem. So let us see how this problem to be done in system. So 11:10 to 12:10, no? 12:10 is a lunch break, right? So I'll leave five, I'll take 5 more minutes time of yours. Just observe. We'll finish up this. Line command 0.15 thickness, and it should be a continuous line. Draw a dark line, I mean XY line. So this is your point X by BP down HP. Okay, so it's a cube of 30 mm sides. Has to be a continuous line, 0.5 thickness. So 30 enter angle is, it should be 45 degree because it's a corner condition. So draw 45 degree line, name the corner. This is A bracket A1. This is BB1. This is CC1. This is DD1. This is OO1. Okay, get the midpoint of it, for which you have to use projection line because it's a prism. Okay, so from here to here one line, then from here to here one line, then draw projection line from each and every corner, from C1 to this, from D1 to XY line, from A1 to XY line. Now axis length, as I said, hexahedral means 6 equal faces, same equal faces. So height also 30. So this button complete here, split, split.
Then again from here, this should be axis line style. Continuous line only, because corners are there. So this is a continuous line. Now name the corners. This is your point C1 dash. This is your point D1 dash of D1 dash, B1 dash of D1 dash, O1 dash, and this is A1 dash. Okay. Then top, this is C dash here, B dash, bracket D dash, D dash, O dash, then last A dash. Okay. Second position, solid diagonal is parallel to XY line. Let us draw this solid diagonal line. It should be projection line. It is not a part of your drawing. It is just for your reference. So from here, draw a solid diagonal line. This has to become parallel. So select the entire thing. Please observe how to do it in the system. Select the entire thing. Go to move command. This line, you take it little bit up. Okay. Then go to rotate command. Taking this as a center, this as a radius, make it parallel. Like this, you make it parallel. Then again, using move command, you can automatically move it. Switch off the copy option. Resting condition point, A1 point has to be on the line, right? So put it on the line. So you mean your A1 point is on XY line. At the same time, this has become parallel also. Solid diagonal has become parallel. Now let us see, for sheet purpose, let us see what is the angle. The angle between this to this, angle from here to here. This is 35. If that is 35, obviously this will be how much? 65, correct? No, sorry, 55. 55 degree, 35 degree. Okay, as I said, this angle, I'll just prove it. This angle measurement is also 55. Okay, so as I said, this angle measurement, you have to take it this way. This angle measurement, you have to take it this side. Okay, in the sheet. So this is how you are going to do it in the sheet. Now drop projection line, C1, it's up to, let us move it all over the ground. So C1 is up to here. Then B1, D1, O1, D1, O1, D1. Then A1 point in the middle, A1. Then C point, D point, everything is merging here. So stop here, then here, this one line, here one more line, this one more line. Here on the board, since I have not taken any measurements, it was overlapping, whereas here I am getting it very perfectly. So this is D1 point, which has to be stopped here. This is D1, right? So one click over here and one more click is over here. Okay. Then here I have CC1, OO1, AA1. So C1, C and O1 over here, A1 and O, and here I have EA, right? So here B1 and B. This is B1 and this is B. Now name the corners. This is A1 dash, B1 dash, C1 dash, and D1 dash, D1 dash, and middle I have O1 dash. Now A dash, this is your point A dash, this is your point B dash, here I have point C dash, and here I have a point B dash. Okay, and here I have O dash. So outermost boundary line dark, don't make yourself more stressed. Observe this very carefully. C1, C1 to B1, B1 to B, B to A, A to D, D to D1, D1 to C1. Now here I have A1 point and C point. A1 point very close to XY line, so A1 related face should be drawn dotted. So A1 related face means A1 to B1 and A1 to D1. So A1 to B1 dotted, then A1 to D1 dotted. At the same time, A1 to A is also dotted. So A1 is here, A is behind that only, so dotted. Then C related face should be drawn dark because C face is very far away. So A to C and D to C should be drawn dark, continuous line. So A to C dark, B dark, and C to C1 dark. Okay. Now solid diagonal is perpendicular. Solid diagonal, I have drawn it from A to C1. A point is over here, C1 point is over here. So that has become perpendicular. As of now, you can see the solid diagonal line is parallel. So go to book command, switch on the copy option, take this A point over here, then using rotate command, rotate it. A point as first click, opposite C1 point as second click, make it perpendicular. So here, solid diagonal became perpendicular to each other. Now draw projection line from each and every corner. This is D1 and D. D1, it is, let us move it on all. So D1 is over here. And next D point is over here. Right? Same way, projection line style. So 0.05. Right? Now on this you have C1, C, A1, A and O. A1, O, C, O, C. So this one is split over here, B1 and B. So this is B1 and this is B, right? Now draw horizontal lines. This is C point, okay? This is B, D and O. So this is D. This is, here I have O and here I have B, right? Then this is A and C1. So C1 and A, both are on the same point. Then over here I have D1, D1, O1. So this is D1, O1, B1. Then A is on the line. So let us name the corners. It will be easy. So this is a point A1 dash. This is a point B1 dash. This is a point, you have to have a lot of patience, C1 dash, this is the point D1 dash, and this is the point O1 dash. Meanwhile, meanwhile, where is your point A? A point is over here itself. So this is a point A dash, then this is a point B dash, this is a point C dash, here you have a point D dash, and here you have a point O dash. Okay, now draw outermost boundary line dark, 0.5 line thickness. Okay, so here A1 to B1, B1, B1 to B, B to C, C to B, B to D1, D1 to A1. Now here, forget your O1 point. A and C1 are the two points which are not attached. A point is very close, C1 point is very far. So A related face should be drawn dark. A related face should be drawn dotted. So A to B, dotted line. A to D, dotted line. A to A1, dotted line. Okay, C1. C1 is very far from XY line, it has to be drawn dark. So change the line style. So D1 to C1 to B1, then C1 to C dark. O to O1 chain line, whether you do it or you are not going to do it, it is not a problem. In this problem, it is not a wrong. So you can leave this. So this is how you are going to get your third position. Okay, I'll stop recording because file size will become more. If you have any doubts, please let me know so that I can clarify.